Jean-Luc Picard is most well known for captaining the Galaxy-class USS Enterprise-D and the Sovereign-class USS Enterprise-E, which is another ship which he captained for almost 20 years, and that was his first command. This would be the USS Stargazer, a ship that is well known and going to become very relevant again in the upcoming Star Trek Picard Season 2, airing on March 3rd, 2022. Today we'll learn more about the ship to further connect it to its legacy in the upcoming Season 2. Hey everyone, welcome to Trek Central, my name is Captain Jack, and let's get straight into it. Of course, Picard is such an important character for the history and future of Star Trek, therefore exploring his first command and one of the ships that turned him into the honourable and much respected captain, and of course later admiral, that he currently is, will be very key to enjoying the character as a whole. It's a no-brainer, but we've come to explore the Constellation-class USS Stargazer once again, especially with Season 2 of Star Trek Picard on the horizon, and the reveal of an even more interesting starship for the future of that series. Of course, if you want to keep up to date on all the latest Star Trek news, lore, and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Trek Central. You can, of course, follow us on social media for daily updates on the Star Trek universe. As always, please let us know your thoughts in the comment section below, because if you're talking about Star Trek, then we want to hear about it. Okay, engage. So, the Constellation class. It was designed to be a vessel for not only deep space exploration, like many Starfleet vessels, but for defensive patrol duty as well. The vessel may have been smaller than the iconic Constitution classes, which were being phased out over time with a length of only 310 meters, but still could fulfill the duties of a Constitution. The style of the ship mirrored a move to around the style of ship design, with no notably secondary hull and saucer section separation, with the nacelles of the ship merely being attached to the rear of the saucer section. However, differing from Miranda, the Constellation had 4 nacelles, 2 above the saucer and 2 underneath the saucer. The Constellation class of vessels was active during the early 24th century. The ship came to be a length of 310 meters spread across 15 decks. The crew complement at the time was 535 crewmen. Indeed, several of these vessels were actually constructed at the Starfleet San Francisco shipyards. The Constellation's max warp speed was warp 9. However, due to the change of the warp scale at the time, it's unknown whether this max speed was using the original series scale or the next generation scale of warp. It was a change necessitated by the increase in warp speeds between the two times. Speaking about tactical armaments, the ship of this class was standard for Starfleet ships at the time, namely our photon torpedoes and of course phasers. Indeed, the ship was capable of firing as many as 6 photon torpedoes in a single spread, making it quite the little beast. So let's talk some lore. From at least 2333, Jean-Luc Picard served as a bridge officer aboard the USS Stargazer. However, at some point, the ship's captain and first officer were killed, and Picard took command of the vessel. Due to how well Picard had handled the situation and took command of the ship, Starfleet Command appointed him as the vessel's new commanding officer. Thus, Jean-Luc would become known as Captain Picard. Many crew members on Jean-Luc Picard's USS Stargazer included Jack Crusher, the husband to Beverly Crusher and father to Wesley Crusher, a weapons officer named Vigo, and a chief medical officer called Moritz Benayoun. Not much is known about the missions involving the Stargazer, and we obviously know the Stargazer was involved in a secret mission to the Fire Force of Kallax. The Stargazer was active during the Cardassian Federation border wars, where the ship was involved in a truce offering by the Federation in Sector 21503. Now, this truce offering was not well received by the Cardassian government, who managed to take out most of the Stargazer's weapons and its impulse engines. Luckily, the Stargazer did manage to escape and flee back to the fleet. There were casualties during some of the missions that the Stargazer went on, as any good Starfleet captain would suffer. The main casualty being that would damage Picard and the morale of the Stargazer was the death of Jack Crusher, who was killed on a away mission in 2353. The biggest incident for the Stargazer was in the year of 2355, when the USS Stargazer was attacked and severely damaged by an unknown vessel in the Maxia Zeta system. This would be known as the Battle of Maxia. During this battle, the Stargazer was able to destroy the attacking vessel, using what would be later be known as the Picard maneuver. The Picard maneuver, while iconic, was when a vessel would suddenly accelerate into high warp directly towards the enemy and drop out of warp. This would cause two vessels to appear on the enemy's sensors due to data still being received from a vessel's former location. Picard was able to destroy the unknown attacking ship using this maneuver, firing at it as soon as they dropped out of warp while the enemy ship was still attacking the data ghost. The Stargazer may have won the Battle of Maxia, but the ship was extremely damaged and had to be abandoned. Even after this incident, Picard was court-martialed for the loss of the Stargazer, and prosecuted by Attorney General Philippa Novar. However, in the end of the trial, he was absolved of all charges. Even though the USS Stargate was presumably destroyed, it would return, salvaged by a Ferengi known as Daemon Bok, who desired revenge against Jean-Luc Picard. It turns out the mysterious ship that had attacked the USS Stargazer at the Battle of Maxia was a Ferengi ship, and Damon Bok's son was in command of that very same ship. Bok even falsified the logs to make it look like the Stargazer was the aggressor and had fired first. The legacy of the Stargazer still lives on with Picard fondly, even recalling his time on the ship, especially to that of Montgomery Scott, the former chief engineer of the original USS Enterprise. Even after years of captaining the flagship of the fleet, the Enterprise-D, Picard would give almost anything to command the Stargazer once again. He even had a model of a Stargazer seen at Picard's section of a quantum archive in the Starfleet Archive Museum. This was in the year of 2399. However, following this incident and Picard seemingly reinstatement of Starfleet, he's taken most of this out of storage and put it inside his office in Chateau Picard. Now, this may be the end of the Stargazer as we know it, but then no ship is ever truly gone in the Star Trek universe. So hopefully the legacy of this is continued throughout the future of Star Trek content, and let's be honest, we know it is. Okay, time for some behind the scenes. Now that may be the lore of the USS Stargazer, but let's look at the background information and behind the scenes of the Stargazer and where it actually came from. Did you know, originally Jean-Luc Picard was going to be called William T. English, and we're kind of glad he wasn't, but according to Gene Roddenberry, in notes from him and his 1986, William English was given the name of Stargazer at the Academy, so Picard eventually was known as Stargazer in the Academy. You know, originally the USS Stargazer was going to be a Constitution-class vessel, the same class as the USS Enterprise which Captain Kirk had commanded. However, it was eventually decided there would be a new model. However, they'd already recorded the lines referring to the Stargate as a Constitution class, so the new vessel had to be a type that sounded close to Constitution and make it easy to overdub, therefore it was called a Constellation class vessel. According to a Starfleet Technical Database article, written for an older magazine by Rick Sternbach, the USS Stargate was eventually repaired after being towed back to Zindi Starbase 9. The starship would then return to limited active duty for 8 years. It would then be further mothballed and stored as a museum ship at the Communist Yard Museum on Luna. That's all our main information out of the way. We do know Picard Season 2 is currently on the horizon, and thanks to new Ready Room featurette and Stargazer.com, we've got confirmation that Admiral Picard's new ship is indeed the USS Stargazer, as we originally expected last year. It looks like Captain Chris Rios will take the stage as the ship's commanding officer, but given his close relation with Jean-Luc Picard, I imagine it will always be the home away from home in a sense. Personally, while the bits I've seen of his new Stargazer are fantastic so far, I hope we see some badass battle scenes. Along with that, finding out what class of ship would be fantastic. Perhaps it's indeed a Stargazer class. A man can dream. Are you excited to see the upcoming USS Stargazer in Star Trek Picard Season 2? Later this week, we'll know more about the ship and get a full breakdown of what we can expect from it in the upcoming seasons. I'm personally super excited to have all that organic and original Starfleet feel back in the show. If you want to be kept up to date on all the latest Star Trek news, lore, and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Trek Central. You can, of course, follow us on social media or join our community Discord server. For now, I've been Captain Jack, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Live long and prosper, my friends. Goodbye.